From News 8 WMTW-TV, this is a News 8 Now update.
Good morning and welcome back to News 8 Now. I'm Tracy Sable. State police are investigating an infant death in Gorham. The call came in around 3:30 Monday afternoon. Police closed the intersection of Highland Avenue and Roby Street near the home where the incident occurred. That intersection has since been reopened. Police have not released any information on the person or persons involved. Just one day after Casey Anthony was released from prison, a local lawmaker here in Maine is calling for new legislation to prevent a similar case from happening here in Maine. Republican Senator Michael Thibodeau of Waldo County plans to submit a measure that would penalize parents or caregivers who do not notify law enforcement of the death or disappearance of a child. Under current law, failing to report a child missing or dead in Maine is not a crime. Casey Anthony was found not guilty of killing her 2-year-old daughter, Kaylee, earlier this month. Three people in Lincoln County are being accused of elder abuse after officers charged them with the felony of endangering the welfare of a dependent person. Police say twins Barbara and Nicholas Davis had their godson Jonathan Stevens left an elderly woman alone for several days in a rental cabin in Edgecombe with little food. The temperature in the cabin registered at more than 100 degrees. Investigators say it appears that the three may have taken the 85-year-old woman from Los Angeles 2 years ago and have been controlling her finances. Investigators say the elderly woman is now at a nearby hospital where they say she is in good condition. The man accused of shooting and killing another man on a Portland street last year took the stand in his own defense in his murder trial on Monday. Dewa Batsisi told jurors that the victim, Serge Malongo, had become increasingly violent in the weeks leading up to the shooting where he was killed. Prosecutors say Batsisi, whose nickname is Kevin, shot Malongo 6 times back in February of 2010 at his apartment off of Park Street. Closing arguments are expected later this week. The Portland City Council has approved a temporary replacement for Police Chief James Craig. Deputy Chief Michael Soschuk was confirmed as the interim chief tonight. Craig, who served as police chief in Portland for a little more than 2 years, will be taking a position as police chief in Cincinnati, Ohio. He'll be sworn in as Cincinnati's new chief on August 2nd. Some Mainers can look forward to better cell phone service in our area. AT&T has announced plans to add and upgrade cell sites here in Maine. The network enhancements are part of the company's 2011 investment plans that will bring 4G speeds to more areas. This year, AT&T has already expanded coverage in places like Bar Harbor, Kittery, and Old Orchard Beach, and that is just a start.
In 2010, we built 25 additional cell sites in our marketplace here in the state. We've also upgraded 60 existing cell sites from 2G to 3G broadband technology. And in this year alone, the first 6 months of 2011, we've expanded our broadband network into 26 additional communities within the state.
AT&T has the nation's largest Wi-Fi network with more than 24,000 hotspots in the U.S. alone. Thanks for joining us here on News 8 Now. I'm Tracy Sable. We'll be right back.